Hey y'all, what's up? I'm here on a YouTube video today. Today's video is going to be about a road rage incident leaves two kids injured. Now, this video is a couple of days old. He was arrested on Saturday. The 9-year-old boy that was shot was released. The 7-year-old girl is in stable condition after she underwent surgery. The suspect is Brian Donald Green. He is 41. He was found in his apartment. Now, this part here really gets me. It really does. Now, his charges are assault with a deadly weapon with intent to kill, okay, and with inflicting serious injury, discharging a weapon into an occupied property, causing bodily injury, and assault by pointing a gun, okay? Three very serious charges, three felonies, okay? Now, some of y'all might say, well, he probably won't get out. Nope, he has a $600,000 bond. Now, I've said this plenty of times in other videos. How do people that do stuff like this get bonds? You know, I really don't get it. He just shot two kids, okay? Could have shot who knows however many people. And he did it because, you know, it could have been a wreck, or he cut them off, they cut him off, whatever the case is. That doesn't justify him shooting two kids. Like, who does that? Like, these kids had nothing to do with it. They weren't even driving. And I don't care if you were trying to shoot the father, whatever. Why would you shoot the father? Were you going to leave the two kids there on the side of the road by themselves? That's stupid. And, like I said, we don't know who these people know or what they do for a living. Like I said, he could be a hitman and he could know Bill Gates for all I know. But yet, you're going to give him a $600,000 bail. For what? So he can go shoot the two kids again, or shoot the father, or for calling 911. Stupid. You know, he could have easily killed these two kids and killed the father. You know, but yeah, he has a $600,000 bail. And whether he gets it or not, okay. If he don't get it, good, I'm glad he don't, but it's the fact that he still had a chance to. And if he does get it, well, you know, he's probably going to be looking for the father, because, you know, I'm pretty sure he's the one that wants to call 911. Just saying. You know, I don't understand how these judges are doing stuff like this. Just like the police, they go out there and arrest the same criminals 20 times. How they keep getting out? The same ones that have an extensive rap sheet, how they keep getting out? The ones that have, like, 6 felonies and keep getting out, okay? You know, I always thought it was 3 strikes, you're out, 3 felonies, you get life in prison no matter what you're what your fourth crime is. What happened to that? You know, some of these judges really need to, you know, be investigated or something, because, like I said, $600,000 bail, that's unacceptable. And a lot of killers now, murderers and stuff like that, they're getting bail. Why? You know, they could easily flee the country. You know, and I don't care about they have to wear an ankle monitor, down to house arrest, whatever. Okay, first off, ankle monitor. Okay. So, one, they could cut it off and leave it at the house and fly wherever. They could take it to the house, middle of the night, break it, go somewhere, you know. Or they could take it and put it in a car with someone they don't even know. Boom, that's in that car. They're 500 miles away. You know, who? That's stupid. And like the house arrest, people definitely don't follow that. They always out. So, you know, all the conditions really don't mean anything. People are going to break that. Especially someone that shoots two people. Yeah, right. They're definitely going to come back to jail and face their charges. Yeah. But, you know, let me know what you guys think about that. If y'all agree with me, if you're just me, why. And thank y'all for watching.